So yeah, just a quick video about the overclocks for, I guess, A4000, A1660s. I got one Ti and one Super. I'm doing this just every day. When I was buying these cars, I was just checking out videos and stuff like that for overclocks and how much mega hash people are getting. Man, this focus is so terrible. And this guy had the guided video. I mean, he was getting like 34 mega hashes out of 1660. I'm not sure, I think he had Super. But he was using, I think, Nice Hash and that Hashimoto algorithm, whatever it's called, I don't know. And he was using like 126 guided watts, you know, to get that. And like efficiency is really terrible. Yeah, efficiency was like 200 something, I cannot remember. If you're watching this, man, I'm gonna tag this video to you just to show you, because I wrote him a comment, you know, that the efficiency is really bad, you can do much better than that. And so I just want to do a video for him, because there's shitloads of videos already on YouTube about 1660 and stuff, but we all have different fucking settings and we all getting different mega hashes. Like Seb did a good video in it, and I was watching Hobbyist Miner, he had a good video, but the VA overclocks, I couldn't get the card, you know, the TI. I couldn't get the TI running over 30, it was running on 27, like under 28 mega hashes, and was using 65 watts, and just like nothing was working. And then I found this guy, what's his name, Vittoris Satori or something, Victor Satori, I think. Yeah, I think Victor Satori. And he was pushing the fucking memory on 1660 to the top. But he was doing it on Windows, and I thought, okay, I'm gonna try it. So what I did, I set it on the TI one on 1100. That's locked core clock in it. So that keeps my wattage really, really low in it. It's sitting on 69. And then I crank the memory up to the top in it. I think I go to 4000 if I'm not mistaken, but I just did 3900. I hope it's like, and I'm getting 31.6. That's fucking very good. It's like 0.45, I think, per watt, you know, of mega hash. That's really good. And I'm hitting 33.6 on a Super, but completely different overclock. I'm still using the core clock, the lock clock shit, you know, that goes, I think, from 1000 to 1100 for 1600s, if I'm not mistaken. And 2200, that would be 1100 on a normal, on afterburner. And that gives me 36, but uses a little bit more power, uses 8180, so that gives me around 0.42 mega hash per watt. That's still like really, really good, because you can get like four of these cards, you know, for much less than 3090 cost, and they are a little bit more efficient than 3090 as well. Just one problem, you need like four slots, you know, instead of one. And this interesting thing, you know, that TI is from Asus. It got a Samsung memory. The other one where is the other one from? MSI. The one is MSI, and they use the Hynix memory. And you see the RTX A4000 uses Samsung memory as well. And overclocks are like, you know, for memory, almost like you looks like a Samsung memory. You can push the memory clock like really, really, really high, and it kind of runs stable over there. I'm not pushing to the top, I'm not putting 4000 in, but I probably could, you know, and probably give me a little bit more or something. But yeah, that's the overclocks for 1660 Super and 1660 Ti. Completely different overclocks to get kind of the same mega hash. I'm getting a little bit lower mega hash on Asus TI, but it's better efficiency, and I'm getting more mega hash, you know, on a super from MSI, but it's a little bit lower efficiency, so it's almost the same, but I would go for efficiency, you know, and because, you know, I mean, 2 mega hashes per 10 watts, that's about right. You get like a, I think a mega hash per 4 or something, like, yeah. But yeah, that's the overclock. So my friend, if you gonna watch this video and I'm gonna send it to you, your efficiency is really bad. You need to improve it, you know. You use a T-Rex miner or use a HiveOS. I had to go to HiveOS because goddamn, these cars got different drivers and they just don't wanna work in Windows, so I had to do it for HiveOS, but I'm pretty happy. HiveOS is pretty cool shit, actually. It's pretty cool shit. I don't need the first screen and stuff like that, you know. I can, you know, I'm just, you know, because you control it from your other PC and stuff, so that works out pretty good. But yeah, it's the video about the efficiency and the overclocks for the cars. And RTX A4000, you know, that one, you can go over 4000, I think, as well, or 2000 if you on a Windows. And people getting 66 out of it, but I don't want to push, like, really, really hard. What's interesting on a 1660 is the temperature. It doesn't show the memory temperature, but the GPU is just so low. I'm keeping it on 85, but 35-30 degrees, I mean, and they really, really small. They even shorter than that A4000. They might even fit in one of my PCs one day if I need to put some somewhere. Well, yeah, so I'm pretty happy. I'm pushing 130 mega hashes, and I'm using, what's that, I think 280, something like that. Yeah, 282 watts. That's like really, really good. That's 0.46, I think, or something, 0.47, something like that. 0.46 something mega hash per watt. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. And it costs me $144 a day. I think, yeah. Yeah, $144 a day. And I don't know what it's making now. Probably like $7 or something, 130. I'm not sure, I need to check. Still profitable, but my friend, if you're gonna watch this video, you know, I mean, nice hash, maybe it's nice and stuff. I'm not really sure, I never used it, but you should use a Windows and use a normal miner like a T-Rex or some other miners that there is. You can get much better efficiency than you have now. What is wrong with this HiveOS? It wouldn't load now. I guess that's the end of the video. Not gonna wait till it's load in. And I'll see you later, I guess. Will it load in now? Should we wait? Let's wait, let's see what it's doing. Let's go back. Let's try again. Will it load in? Don't wanna load in now, I see. That's the overclock for each card, actually. Oh, that's the good shit I found for the end of the video, if somebody wanna copy. A4000 on the top, that's the overclocks. You can try this overclocks even you in the Windows, I think. I'm not sure, but you probably can. Fan doesn't matter, fan you can set from how much you want, but I set it on 85, but 85, that's where the sound disappears. It's gonna run them on 100, they're pretty loud actually on 1660s. On A4000 it's not, that's why I keep it on 100, but other ones are pretty loud. So yeah, that's the overclocks of the cards. and that works out like really, really efficient, you know. I'm pretty happy. I might get another one of these or another two of these because I cannot get A4000s. I can, but they're just too expensive. One A4000 is now, you can get three 1660s for one A4000 price, so I mean, it's no brainer. I would go for 90 mega hashes, you know, rather than for 60. Even if his efficiency a bit lower, still. So, okay, I'll see you on another one. I'm gonna do on a video update on a rig, because I'm waiting for some cables to come in. I wanna do a little video about the Molex connections and stuff like that. But that's the overclocks, and I'll see you later.